Why you lie, right in my eyes? You told me you was gonna stay by my side. I guess I'm right, ain't always wrong. But baby, you cannot just walk in my life. I don't apply for what you done. My mother.
I got private on my ass. I got slimes, they pull up fast. Put a quarter on your ass. Get your body for a pack. Big ass Jago, big ass seed. I just made her swallow my keys. Big ass Jago, big ass seed.
Yo, what is up, gang? Caleb here, back with another video. And today, we're talking about Level 2-4 album review. Now, make sure you check out the merch, bro. You know, it's lit. It's cheap, you know, got long sleeve and short sleeve. Make sure you check it out. You don't want to miss out. Might even have some more shirts in the new year. Now, on to this album, you know. So I will say I listened to it the first time and I was like, I felt like I missed something or something like that. And then I had to listen to it a second time today. So, and I didn't miss anything, you know. And before I say what I really feel about this album, let me get to the positives about the album. Trippie has good hooks, you know, great hooks. Some of the features are really good, like Juice WRLD, good. Like Juice WRLD don't really fail to be good. Compared to Explanation Mark, you know, it's more of an album. It's more focused compared to where Explanation Mark was just all over the place and didn't know what it wanted to be and full of throwaways. The album has good moments. Now, let's go to the negative, bro. And, you know, I try not to be negative. Like I said, this is a better album than Explanation Mark, but here we go. And a lot of people might disagree with me or not. I really don't care because it's my opinion. You're entitled to your own opinion too. So to jump from a Love Letter 2-3 to a Love Letter 2-4 is a pretty big jump, bro. You could tell the difference compared to the two albums together, you know. Listen, front and back, there are honestly moments on the album whenever you feel like he's losing steam. Like, bro, he'll have a good hook or a good start of a song, and then from there it kind of goes downhill. And this happens on a lot of these songs. And you notice there's kind of a repetition on these songs. There's one or two things happening on these songs. Either he's talking about shooting somebody or he's talking about having sex with a girl, bro. It's so repetitive. You know, I don't like it, bro. I hate that, you know, because it gets old after you repeat it for 5 or 6 songs and it doesn't sound any different. And I'm sure some of y'all that listen know what I'm talking about. Like, he'll start off really hot on a song and a song will go downhill. And then also he'll mention about shooting somebody. Like, some songs it works. Like Death, it works perfectly, but you know, other songs, it doesn't make any sense. If you're talking about love and like what happened to your relationship, why are you talking about having sex with another girl? Like, that don't make no sense. And we can also mention how bad Smoke Perp sounded on this album, bro. He sounded terrible. The auto-tune was really bad for him. And like I previously mentioned, these songs have moments, but the moments come so late in the song. Like, when you listen to snippets, the snippets sound way better than some of the songs that are actually on the album. Like the song Chosen, bro, I expect that to be way hotter. Way hotter, like. And what I'm really getting to is that this album, you know, listen to it, is mainly like love or sad songs. And you're like, okay, bro, where's the hype? Where's the trap on this album? And it comes very late, you know. You see, Love Letter 2-3 had the perfect mix of trap and R&B, you know, and that works so well. And it's sad and it's fun at the same time. And this album is just, okay, we want to just be sad the whole time. So what is the point if you're going to name this album hip-hop and rap under that category if it's going to be a little bit of hip-hop and rap and a lot of R&B? That doesn't make any sense. And here's where the main frustration comes from, bro. If you look at a relationship like, I don't know, Trippie and Alex, that was for years, bro. Years. So the album had to be good. The album had to be great. And it was. And you look at a relationship like Trippie Redd and Coi Leray, where the relationship didn't even last a year. Didn't even last a year, bro. What was it? 6, maybe 7 months? And then they got back together and then broke up after less than a month. He's literally showing you which relationship is more important and which relationship is just there for the sake of having a relationship. Like, he even says it in this album, I wasn't even looking for happiness, just less pain, you know. So it tells you right there that this album should probably never even came out. Moral of the story, bro, is that this looks rushed. You know, you go back and you look at Lysa Tripp's album sales and look at Lover 2, 3 album sales, and they're great. And then go to exclamation mark, album sales are crap. And there's a reason for that. And now he put 21 songs on the album to make more money because the first album didn't sell well. Bottom line, it feels like Trippy just rushed through an album to get the bad taste out of our mouths and to get more streams. But if you really think about it, who was really streaming exclamation mark? Like, nobody really was. So that tells you a lot, a whole lot. So expecting more. Now, I'm not even saying this is a bad album, but I'm just disappointed. There's so many moments that could have been expanded upon, and it could have been a whole lot better than it was. So what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below. If you did enjoy the video, hit the like button. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see the rest of you guys later. Hey, you. Yeah, you. I see you sitting there. Let me ask you, how do you feel about Trippy Redd? Okay. How do you feel about Travis Scott? Okay. How you feel about Playboi Carti? You know what? How you feel about Lil Uzi? Like, these are one of the best in the game. Okay, so if you like all these, this is probably the channel for you. As well as some of your favorite artists. So what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button. I'll wait.